Hello students and welcome back to Edupedia World. My name is Shivam Mishra and I am a BTech from IIT BHU. Today we will be discussing JEE Advanced 2013 Chemistry Paper 2. The paper code which we are using is 3. So let us look at the questions one by one. Okay students, let us look at question number 20. Question number 20 is from electrochemistry and it is based upon the concept that delta G for a given spontaneous reaction is an extensive properties, that is when we add two reactions the delta G of the reactions can be added, whereas, or let's say if we multiply a reaction by a particular number then delta G gets multiplied by that same number, whereas E naught or for that matter E is a intensive property, right? So it's a very good conceptual question on this particular concept. Let us have a look at the options one by one. In the first case, that is in option P, we have been asked to calculate Fe3 naught, that is the standard reduction potential of conversion of Fe3 plus into Fe, and the data which we have been provided is E naught for the conversion of Fe plus 3 to Fe plus 2, that is ferric to ferrous, and then Fe plus 2 to Fe. Fine. So let me take you to the solution, and I have just copied the data from the previous page wherein we have been given the standard reduction potentials. Now we have been given the standard reduction potential of Fe plus 3, I am writing the reactions also, plus electron goes to Fe plus 2. We have been given the SRP for this reaction, and then similarly we have been given the SRP for Fe plus 2 plus 2 electrons goes to Fe. Okay, these are the two SRP values for the reactions which we have been given. And then we have been asked to calculate the Fe plus for the SRP for the conversion of Fe plus 3 into Fe. So basically if I add the two reactions, I will get Fe plus 3 plus 3 electrons goes to Fe. Okay. And from the concept of delta G, I know that if for this reaction the Gibbs free energy change is delta G1, and if for this reaction it is delta G2, and let us say if for this reaction it is delta G, then definitely I can write down delta G will be equal to delta G1 plus delta G2. Okay, and delta G1 for this particular reaction will be minus n Fe0, that is n is the number of electrons involved, so it will be minus 1 into F into the E0 value, that is 0.77. Okay, and similarly for this reaction delta G2 will be equal to minus n, that is 2 into F into the SRP value which has been given as minus 0.44, and for this reaction delta G will be, there are 3 electrons involved, so it will be minus 3 into F into E0 which we have to calculate. So now I simply need to substitute the three values in the given equation. F, as we all know, I will just substitute the exact values and then I will show you the calculation. Minus 3 into F into E0, and delta G will become minus 1 into F into 0.77, and similarly delta G2 will become minus 2 into F into minus 0.44. okay, F being the common factor will be cancelled out, and I will be left with, if I multiply with a minus sign all throughout, I will be left with 3 E0 equals 0.77 minus, this minus will become plus, but since there is one more minus, minus 0.88. okay, so this will leave me with 3 E0 is equal to minus 0.11, and this will leave me with E0 as minus 0.11 by 3. So this is the answer which I am getting, and if I take you back to the four options, minus 0.11 by 3, if I solve it further, this would become minus 0.0 and
this will divide by 36 minus 0.036 volt, and in the option rounding it off I can approximate it as 3. That is, I can match my option P with 3. Fine. And now if I look at the options, I find that only in D. So you can see only with the help of one question I can solve the rest of the options by elimination process. But still, from knowledge point of view, we will discuss each of the options Q, R and S. Okay, so let us look at option Q now. In option Q, we have been asked to calculate the potential of the reaction 4H2O goes to 4H plus plus 4OH minus. Now, first of all, let me tell you that this is not a half cell reaction. This is a complete reaction. And for a complete reaction, the reduction potential or the overall potential can be calculated as the sum of two half cell reactions. Okay, that is the oxidation half as well as the reduction half. So now let me take you to the solution, and we are going to calculate it with the help of data given over here. That is E naught for this particular reaction and E naught for this particular reaction. These are the two half cell reactions which we have been given. Okay. So now I have just copied the data from the previous page. And if I look at the target reaction which I have to reach, that is 4H2O goes to 4H plus plus 4OH minus. Now clearly 4H plus over here is on the reactant side, and in the final reaction I need it on the product side. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just simply reverse this reaction and write it over here. That is 2H2O goes to 4H plus plus O2 gas plus 4 electron. I have just written this reaction in reverse form, and once I have reversed it, its overall potential on reversing the reaction will also get a negative sign. That is, it will now become minus 1.23 volts. Okay, and this reaction I am going to write as it is because I need OH minus on the product side and it is already on the product side. So I will simply write O2 gas plus 2H2O, fine, plus 2H2O plus 4 electrons goes to 4OH minus, fine. And the reduction potential for this particular reaction would be plus 0.4 volt, which I have simply copied from here, the data which has been given to us in the question. And now if I add both these reactions, what happens is that this 4 electron gets cancelled out, this O2 and O2 over here gets cancelled out, and what we are left with is our target reaction of 4H2O goes to 4H plus plus 4OH minus. Now this is an overall reaction which has been derived by the summation of two half cell reactions, and its E naught would simply be the sum of these two, that is minus 1.23 volt plus 0.40 volt, and this would give me the answer as minus 0.83 volt. Fine. So if I just take you back to the options for Q, I will match with option number 4 over here. See, minus 0.83 volt. Okay. So again, it is matching with option D. And now we are going to check out options R and S. Okay, students, let us look at option R now. Now, option R is again a complete reaction, and this is basically a comp proportionation reaction, and these are the two half cell reactions for it, wherein Cu2 plus plus electron goes to Cu plus. This is the reduction half and this is the oxidation half. Now, if we are able to figure out the electrode potentials of these two reactions, on adding the two reactions, I am going to get this desired reaction, and their reduction potentials can be added. Okay, like we had did in option Q. So the data which we are going to use is this data over here, wherein I have been given these two values. Fine. I have just copied this data from here on the next page. So these are the reduction potentials which we have been given. So let me draw a quick diagram for you. I know the reduction potential of Cu2 plus to Cu. So I'm just representing the species in a sequential order, Cu2 plus, Cu plus 1 and Cu. And I know this reduction potential, this has been given to me, as well as I know this reduction potential, this also has been given to me. And I need to calculate this value. So let me call it X. And now we all know that delta G can be added for the two reactions. So I am simply going to write minus X into F into 1, and for this particular reaction I am going to write minus 1 into F into, because one electron is involved, into 0.52 is equal to, for the overall reaction, as number of electrons would be 2, so it would be minus 2 into F into the reduction potential, that is 0.34 volt. Okay, and now you can see that X, F, F and F will get cancelled out, and I will be left with X plus 0.52 is equal to 2 into 0.34, that would be 0.68 volt, and subtracting the two I will get X is equal to 0.16 volt. Fine, so this will be my reduction potential of the reaction. Cu2 plus plus electron goes to Cu plus 1, and this value is 0.16 volts. Okay, and similarly, if I write the other oxidation reaction, that is Cu goes to Cu plus 1 plus electron, and this reduction potential will be the reverse of 0.52, that is, because if the reaction is reversed, the cell potential will also be reversed, minus 0.52 volt. And now if I basically add the two reactions, I will get my desired reaction of comp proportionation, that is Cu2 plus plus Cu goes to twice of Cu plus 1. Fine, this is the overall reaction which we have been given, and for this reaction the overall cell potential would come out to be minus 0. If you simply add the two values, minus 0.36 volt. This will be the correct answer. However, if you look at the option, that is option R has been matched with 1, which is minus 0.18 volt. So this was one, perhaps one mistake in IIT. This should be not minus 0.18 volt. It should be minus 0.36 volt over here. So this is one correction which we need to do. Okay, so that finally brings us to option S. In option S, we have again been given a half cell reaction, and these are the two data which we are going to use. We know the SRP of the conversion of Cr plus 3 to Cr. Similarly, we know it for Cr plus 2 to Cr, and we have been asked to calculate for Cr plus 3 to Cr plus 2. Okay, so I will just represent the reactions one by one on the next page. These are the two data which I have copied from the previous page. This is minus 0.74, minus 0.74, and this is minus 0.91. Okay, so our target equation was Cr plus 3 plus electron goes to Cr plus 2. Let us call it E naught. And another equation was, which we are given, that is Cr plus 2 plus 2 electron goes to Cr. Let us say for this reaction delta G is delta G1, for this reaction it is delta G2, and if I add the two reactions, I am going to get Cr plus 3 plus 3 electron goes to Cr. This is, let's say, called delta G. Now, as always, delta G will be equal to, I'm just writing the relations here, delta G will be equal to delta G1 plus delta G2. And now we simply need to write both the values in terms of the cell potential, that is minus NF E0. So delta G will be written as minus 3 into F, because 3 electrons are involved, into minus 0.74, and delta G1 will be written as minus 1 into F into E0. We need to calculate E0 over here, and delta G2 will be written as minus 2 into F into the value, that is minus of 0.91. okay, and F and F being the common factor gets cancelled out, and we are left with the required equation. If I multiply it with a minus sign all throughout, it would be minus 2.22 equals to minus sign. We have multiplied by a minus sign, and this would be E naught, and this would be minus 1.82. Now using this reaction, we can simply solve it, and we would get minus 2.22 plus 1.82, and this I think would be minus 0.4 volt. So if I take you back to the options, you can clearly find it in option 2, that is my S is going to match with option 2. Thank you very much.